Beast hunting time, and this time we're going to do it with smokescreen. What's up, people? This is Mitch Santona, and I got a little Skyclaw action today to show you. Comes with smokescreen, so it's a ship with a claw, chompy claw. He sits on the side on a big cannon. Looks like you can throw Bumblebee on there to just, you know, help him out a little bit. It does come, here's the cross cell here now, this Apex Hunter Armor with Breakdown, which, if you give me a second, I have that too. So that'll be reviewed next, probably right next. And here's just some of the stuff on the box. Comes with a Legion class smokescreen. And yeah, here's the technical data if you're into that sort of thing. I want to get him out of here now, shall we? Okay, so before we get into the playset aspect of this review, let's just take a look at smokescreen up close and personal. And I gotta say, this is a fun little Cyberverse figure. Now, he's blue and yellow. He looks like the old U of M Wolverine colors, but I wish he was white because this is a cool little mold. I'm going to transform him in 2 seconds, but I just want to give you a little spin around. And we'll throw in Bumblebee for a little comparison. So that's what they look like together. Yeah, very neat. Let me get transforming this guy. I'll show you something cool. Now, the transformation on this guy is a little bit tricky. You actually kind of have to do it a little bit simultaneously when you start flipping things out. And I'll see if I can get this to work first time. But you got to get these panels here in front of his chest before you pull that down so that you can push that back. Okay, there you go. So yeah, or else it will get caught, I guess. So that's the way it's supposed to go down. Tried that several times on camera and failed. But yeah, there is smokescreen. And he does look really neat here. Let's try to get this clicked in. There we go. That will click in. And yeah, I love that mold. I wish he was just white because that's a really cool little Cyberverse dude. I like playing with it. I like messing with it. I like cool intuitive transformations. And I like a little smokescreen. And so here he is with his little buddy Bumblebee. And he's a little bit taller than Bumblebee. He's actually a little bit bigger of a figure. So that's kind of nice. Here is the Skyclaw. And this thing is bright and yellow and blue and just popping. And it's actually decently sized, too. It's got a nice weight to it. And rather cool. I like the aesthetic of this. Now, I believe this is in stealth mode, for what it's worth. So, like, none of the weapons or anything are deployed in this mode. It's just how it sits. So, I'll take a look at some of the gimmicks here in a bit. But just want to show this off, show you what it looks like from all different angles. And, yeah, let's look at some of the gimmicks a little bit closer. Firstly, the cockpit will open up, and it's pretty huge in there. You could store probably more than one Cyberverse figure in there. You could probably throw a couple in there, maybe a little snack for later, just whatever you want. Just store it in the cockpit, and yep, away you go. Of course, it's got ports in various areas, so you can, you know, add Cyberverse weaponry. Now, it's got a trigger where my thumb is here, and I'm going to try to deploy everything at once, see if you can, I can get it all on camera and see if you can see it all. But as you pull down, you see it does like an auto morph. The engines come out, it spins this bottom portion around and deploys this little laser gun in the front. All right, so here's the front of the vehicle. You just saw where the gun is at here. If you flip it over, you'll notice some big, well, claws that are undeployed. If you'd like to deploy them, there's another trigger. You can kind of put your hand there and you can grab something. What's kind of neat too is that these claws are individually spring-loaded with torsion springs, so they will actually hold things. There's enough pressure there to actually physically pick something up, unlike that stupid claw game at Chuck E. Cheese, which couldn't pick up a cotton ball. So there's a little bit of poseability in these wings. If you don't like, I guess, the look of that, you can actually put those down, and then you can just raise up these individual fins here, which that gives it almost like an aquatic look, and that doesn't look too bad either. All right, the right side engine here, this stuff all unfolds so that you can use a Cyberverse dude. This will slide open that way. That's on another torsion spring. It drops down those little guys there so they can have somewhere to put their feet. And now you've got this little gunnery station with a big old cannon, liking that. Also, I should point out that it came with 4 big gray missiles. One fits here, and then 3 will fit in this guy here. We'll take a look at that now, too. All right, same with on the other side. You can pick this up. And then you can get your little Cyberverse dude to, you know, hold this. And then he can pretend like he's aiming. You twist this guy here, and it should fire missiles across the room. I love that Gatling gun effect. That's so neat. And the other side just fires by pushing this yellow thing. couple other little, I guess, options too is that you can put your missiles up here with these on these little wingy dings up front, and then also you can deploy the claw by pushing that thing in. Another option as to how to fire this thing, rather than pushing on this yellow bit, you can squeeze these two together, and that's got some force. Just to show that off, smokescreen does in fact fit in the cockpit, and that's how he does it. So just to do a little size comparison here for you, there's the Skyhammer on the right, Wheeljack ship. Now, that's a little smaller, but it does have LEDs, so I don't know. They look good together, I can tell you that. That's going to do it, folks. This has been Mitch Santona. You've just seen Skyclaw with Smokescreen, the Cyberverse playset that I do quite like and recommend because it's got a lot of playability, and it's just fun. Tons of gimmicks all over it. Thumbs up on that. Kind of dig this thing. Oh, it looks really pretty, too. But yeah, hey, got a contest going on right now. If you guys are interested in winning some free stuff from me, check out my Happy Meal video. I've got a set that I'm giving away, and I'm going to be giving it away soon, so get in on it if you haven't. Come check out my second channel. Hook me up on Twitter. Just look at me on Facebook. Just I'm all over the place. Come get involved. I'll see you guys later. Take care, and have a good day.